Good evening and welcome, my dear prayer pals, to our Monday Thursday prayer of Vespers. And it's lovely to welcome our dear sister Bernadine, who's joined me with brother Joe on our Facebook page. Blessings to you both, to our dear sister Lynn and sister Suzanne, who've joined me on our Whereby Prayer video channel, and to those who will join me on YouTube. Bless your heart. Thank you for letting me pray with you this evening. As you will have noticed, there's a candle lit behind me, dedicated to the Archangel Princess of Peace, for the cessation of violence from Israel towards the innocent women, children, and men of Gaza, and that the food lorries that are waiting to be allowed into Gaza will be given permission by the Knesset in Jerusalem. We pray for the starving children and the young mums who've given birth with no milk to feed their young ones. We pray for them. And we pray for the children of God, of Abraham's God, who inflicts suffering on all faiths. And we remember persecuted Christians in Cairo, our Coptic brothers and sisters, who paid the price for their witness to Christ from fundamentalists, as I discovered when I ran a retreat there several years ago. And it's lovely to welcome our dear brother Matthew, who's been unwell for some time. This is my Lenten candle, dedicated to the Messianic Jesus. It's a symbol of my faith and of the Christ light. And I wish to share the Christ light with your heart on this Monday, Thursday evening. Let us focus on the flame that it may burn bright within your soul as we reawaken to what is the Christ saying to you on this Easter Triduum of Monday, Thursday, Good Friday, and Holy Saturday. We pray the mantra of Jesus. Here we are, Lord, as God's prayer partners on earth. Show us how we may serve your Father in heaven, on earth, at this hour. Amen. And now, my dear friends, as the Holy Spirit has prepared our evening prayer and chosen some beautiful videos that we will play on our Whereby video prayer channel, it's important to express gratitude and also to invoke the Holy Spirit to open the door of your heart so that we can sing the praises of God. And I wonder who that could be. Remember in prayer this evening a very dear friend of the community here in Cumbria, whose name is Sister Fran, who was rushed into hospital early this morning to Barrow with sepsis. I understand the feelings of sepsis only too well, having got it myself a year last December, where I had to be resuscitated here by the paramedics. So let us send love, light, and blessing to dear Sister Fran. Now let us begin the office of Vespers. O God, come to my aid. O Lord, make haste and help me. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Our opening prayer for Holy Week is from this wonderful book by Ray Simpson, The Complete Celtic Prayer. And for Passion Week, we read the following prayer. The one who created us comes willingly to suffer for us. Let us spread our resolves before him like branches of palm. Praise the Lord. Prayer answered. The Almighty comes to us as one gentle and lowly of heart. Let us put on clothes of humility and praise. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. Let us watch and wait with him this Monday, Thursday. Amen. And Spirit has chosen for us a psalm, Psalm 50. So allow me to locate the video for you and share it with your heart. That was a lovely choir from the Catholic Church in Africa. Psalm 50. Spirit has chosen two psalms for us this evening from the book Psalms Now. I do recommend the book. And the first psalm is a modern version of Psalm 32. The person who knows the meaning of forgiveness, who is no longer plagued by past failures, but who stands blameless and guilt-free before God, that person is rich indeed. Every time I attempt to handle my own guilt by ignoring it, rationalizing it, or just running away from it. Some unseen power or pressure from the depths of my being squeeze my life dry, leaving me empty. But when I face up to my failures and confess them, when I open my guilt-ridden heart to you, O God, then I realize the blessed meaning of forgiveness. Thus, everyone who claims faith in a loving God needs to cling to his acceptance and concern. Times of darkness will come. Life storms and tempests, they will continue to rage. But the faithful shall not be destroyed. You are, O God, a place of refuge. You enable us to face our problems and keep us from being destroyed by them. And even within the darkness surrounding us, in the midst of life's turmoil, I can hear the voice of God. Even these things serve a purpose in your life. Don't sell them short, for they are steps along my path for you. Stop being stubborn and stupid, like some undiscerning jackass that has to be driven by sticks or whips. The faithful and the faithless both suffer the uncertainties and securities of this life. But the children of God can always depend on the love of their Father. It is for this reason that there is light even in the midst of darkness, incomprehensible joy in the midst of sorrow, and we can find a measure of happiness and well-being regardless of the circumstances that surround us. These are the inspired words from a loving God for you. Thanks be to you, O God. And following the psalm, apart from being pestered by Brother Sid, who's right beside me, oh, I tell you, this boy, he's got no monastic manners. Let us play for you the next video, which is, O Lord, my God. So let us, here we are. Now, go to bed. Bed, goodbye.
Lord, my God, I will keep.
What a lovely, lovely sacred tune. I will keep on praising your name forever. That's why you and I are here. We were called by name, by the divine essence within us, to unite as prayer paths for God on earth, and to hold all the children of God who are wounded, who are suffering and struggling. And it is a pleasure and a joy to be able to pray with you for our brothers and sisters around the world who need God's love. Now, our second psalm that was chosen in prayer early this morning is a modern version of Psalm 116. I know that God is here. I know this because my soul bare and my body naked before him. He looked on me with love and responded to my cry for help. There was a time when I didn't care. I was not aware of any particular need for him. But then I hit rock bottom. Death itself reached out to embrace me. There was no one else to turn to. I cried out to God in my desperation. I could almost feel his invisible hand encircle me and draw me close to himself. Now I am convinced God is here and I shall trust him forever. I will no longer wait for pain or suffering to drive me to him. I will walk in his course for my life. I am committed to his purposes, and I intend to carry out that commitment. I can never repay God for his ever-present love. I can only dedicate my life to praising him and to serving him wherever I may be. I am his servant and his child, and I shall love him forever. I shall proclaim to all the world that God is in our midst. And these are the inspired words from a loving God for your heart and mind this evening. Thanks be to you, O Lord. Amen. The next video chosen in prayer early this morning is called Jesus Paid It All. I just wish that those of you on YouTube and Facebook were able to come over to our Whereby Prayer channel and be able to see the wonderful videos that God's Spirit has prepared for us. So Jesus paid it all. Let's find the video. Here we are.
Calvary's hill, Jesus paid it.
That was a lovely video. And yes, Jesus did pay it all. But what did he pay? He paid for our sin. He paid for original sin that we inherited from Adam and Eve. But he went to Calvary out of love. I struggle with that, even as an old monk, having been in service to Christ since I entered the monastery back in June 66. I always struggle with Good Friday. I know I weep many tears when I think now of what Jesus did for me. I am no plaster cast saint, and I'm certainly not a holy Joe. I'm human like you. I have good days and I've crap days. I've days when I sense despair, when life's challenges really hit you hard. But I know now, after all these years, that whatever challenge we have to face, whatever cross we have to carry in love, Jesus paid it all. And he knows our weakness. He knows our need. And he never turns away. He's always there. This leads me now to our reflection for Lent from the wonderful book Lent with St. Francis of Assisi. And Francis has chosen as his theme for this evening, for Maundy Thursday, one word, the Eucharist. And from 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23, he shares the following: I received from the Lord what I also handed unto you. St. Francis was always devoted to the Eucharist. It's one of the reasons he was so concerned about rebuilding and cleaning local churches, making them suitable homes for the Eucharist. Thomas of Celano tells us that concerned citizens brought St. Francis to their parish priest, who was living in sin. They wanted the saint to reprimand him and condemn his sinful way of life. Instead, St. Francis knelt, took the priest's hand and said, I know not whether this priest is sinful. I only know that these hands alone make present upon the altar my Lord and my Saviour, Jesus Christ. Francis' respect for the clergy was based on the priest's power to change bread and wine into the body and blood of Christ, in whom all things in heaven and on earth are made peaceful and are reconciled to God the Almighty. The church of his day was no stranger to scandal and corruption. He reminds us that there's more to the church than the human institution, that the Holy Spirit continues to guide the church throughout history, even when it appears all seem to the contrary. Today's gospel account of Jesus washing the disciples' feet offers an antidote to the problems our human church encounters. Let us take a pause and just reflect on those few words as we come to the next video. God is calling you back. Well, he's certainly calling me back every waking moment when he says, do you still love me as I love you? How do you answer that? when Jesus in your quiet time says, "Hello, you do know I love you." What do you say? Was a disturbing video of watching Jesus being shredded to bits and nailed to a cross. But what was most upsetting was to see his own mother watching her son. We need these gentle reminders, don't we? Because we become so forgetful and complacent, even in our belief. There are so many who say, "Oh, I love Jesus, I love God, I gave him my heart." But Jesus reminds us they give lip service because their hearts are closed. Their hearts are closed to that gentle voice of their first love. Not the young boy or girl behind the bicycle shed at school. Our first love is Christ. He knelt with us in spirit before we were born, adoring a loving Father. And it's important for me, because I forget. And in my forgetfulness, I don't do him any justice by whitewashing Good Friday. Good Friday, for me, is a demonstration of one of the greatest love stories ever to be told, that a young man chose to give his life out of love for you and for me, and he asked nothing. He didn't even ask for you to become a convert. All he asks, are you willing to keep your heart open, to be still, like Francis, to come into your cave, whether it's your lounge, on your balcony, in your garden, under a tree, and just say, "Here I am, Lord. I've come home to you because I need you. I need Jesus now more than I've ever needed him, because I realize in old age I'm far from being perfect. I'm still a student monk learning the craft, and it doesn't get easier. It becomes more challenging because the mind wants to make excuses. Oh, I'll say my prayers later." And when later comes, you're so exhausted you fall asleep. That's not prayer. Prayer is making a determined effort to say thank you. Thank you to a loving God who's provided our abundance, our many blessings. Let's conclude, Francis. Francis said, I did not come to serve, to be served, but to serve. Matthew 20, verse 28. Our Lord tells us this, and those who are put in charge of others should be no more prouder of their office than if they had been appointed to us to wash our feet and to speak with us. Sorry, I got confused there for a moment. They should be no more upset at the loss of their authority than they would if they were deprived of the task. The task of washing the feet, the more they are upset, the greater the risk they incur to their souls. Brother Matthew has asked to speak. Speak, dear brother. I can hear you, Matthew.
Oh, I'm sorry. I wasn't trying to. I apologize.
It's okay. I thought you wanted to speak. Okay, let's move on then. But lovely, lovely to know you're there, Matthew. We come now into the stillness. And in the stillness, let us reflect on the scripture reading for Monday, Thursday, Vespers, from the Divine Office of Vespers. It's from one of the letters of St. Paul to the Hebrews, chapter 13, verses 12 to 13. Jesus suffered outside the gate to sanctify the people with his own blood. Let us go to him then, outside the camp, and share in his degradation. For there is no eternal city for us in this life, but we look for the one in the life to come. Through him, let us offer God as an unending sacrifice of praise, a verbal sacrifice that is offered every time we acknowledge the name of the Messianic Jesus. These are the inspired words from a loving God. Thanks be to you, O Lord. And our short responsory for Vespers, or in place of the responsory, we pray, Christ humbled himself for us, and in obedience he accepted death. The Magnificat antiphon, as they were eating, Jesus took bread, and when he had said the blessing, he broke it and he gave it to his disciples. Usually following the antiphon, we play the Magnificat, the Canticle of Mary, the Mother of Jesus. So allow me to find the video that was chosen for us. Here we are. My soul magnifies the Lord.
Yeah.
That was certainly a different version of the Magnificat, but it was the one that Spirit chose, so we follow his instructions rather than my own. Let us now come to the intercessions for this Thursday evening Vespers. Let us adore our Saviour, who at the Last Supper, on the night he was betrayed, entrusted to the Church the memorial of his death and his resurrection, to be celebrated throughout the ages. Confident that he will hear us, we pray, and the response is, sanctify the people you redeemed by your blood. Christ our Redeemer, let us share in your passion by works of patience. Penance, forgive me. Let us attain the glory of your resurrection. Response, sanctify the people whom you redeem by your blood. Grant us the protection of your mother, the comforter of the afflicted. May we bring to others the consolation that you have given to us. And the response is, sanctify the people whom you redeem by your blood. Unite the faithful to your passion in times of trouble and distress. Let the power of your salvation shine forth in their lives. Response, sanctify the people you redeem by your blood. You humbled yourself even to accepting death, death on a cross. Grant to us, your servants gathered here, obedience and patience. Response, sanctify the people you redeem by your blood. Share with the dead your bodily glory. Let us rejoice one day with them in the fellowship of the saints, and especially with the fellowship of our own brothers and sisters from the Teo community who are with the Lord. Dear Sister Sandy from Texas, Sister Nancy from Oregon, Sister Rita and Brother Jean-Marie from Belgium, Sister Linda from Philadelphia, Sister Anne from Cumbria, and our dear Brother Andrew from Scotland. With them and all the saints, we are gathered here to just say thank you, Lord, for what you did for us on Good Friday. Let us spend a minute or two just in quiet contemplation and just visualize that you are at the table with the Lord. A place has been set for you with the 12 apostles, and you witness the betrayal of Jesus by one of his own, Judas Iscariot. But you are there to receive the bread and the wine from the Lord. How do you respond when the plate of bread, now his body, and the goblet of wine, now his blood, how do you receive it? Do you pass it on? Or do you reverently come into silence and say, my Lord and my God, I love you because I need you. And if you have a request, Jesus already knows what it is, so why not ask? And then say thank you. So many of God's children email me, they never include my name or say thank you. It's more or less bullying tactics to pray for their many, many wants, not their needs. Christ doesn't do want, he only does need. So whatever your needs are right now, name them and bless them because they're yours. Present them to Christ, and then a prayer of gratitude. Let us bring you to Christ, your first love. Hello, Sid. as you gaze on the beautiful face of Jesus, now being shown on our Whereby Prayer video channel, Spirit guided my heart to pick up the little book Jesus Calling and to share with your heart a channeled message from Jesus for this Monday, Thursday evening. I am a God who gives and gives and gives. When I died for you on the cross, I held back nothing. I poured out my life like a drink offering, because giving is inherent in my nature. I search for people who are able to receive in full measure, to increase your intimacy with me. The two traits you need the most are receptivity and attentiveness. Receptivity is an opening up your innermost being to be filled with my abundant riches. Attentiveness is directing your gaze to me, searching for me in all your moments. It is possible to stay your mind on me. As the prophet Isaiah wrote, through such attentiveness, you receive a glorious gift, my perfect peace. And at the table with Jesus and the 12 apostles, now 11, because Judas has left to betray his master to the chief priests for a miserable 30 pieces of silver. But you gaze on the face of Jesus and you know what happened to him because of history. You know that he had to do this for you and for me so that we could be free to be prayer pals for his Father on earth, where there is no ego, there is no more excuses, but a loving response when he looks at you in the eyes and says, will you betray me too? Will you walk away when the children of God need you? You are a prayer pal for God. I anointed you and I appointed you to hold the children of Abraham's God, to be touched by the smile of their loving Father. Jesus calls you to himself, and he leads you away from the table of 11, and he wants to take you in his arms. He wants to hold you, to caress you, and to touch you. And in those arms, your heart is beating the same beat as that of Christ. And in that tender embrace, all your faults and failings and excuses are forgiven. And all he asks, do you really love me? Do you really love me? And he sends you away to reflect on those words. Let us now bring our evening prayer to a close, and as we do, let us be mindful of the Lord's Prayer. And the Spirit has already chosen the video of the Lord's Prayer, which I would like to play for you now.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
I love those kind of prayers, short and sweet. We bow our head, and we hear the message from the Father, from Jesus, for you who have said, "Yes, Lord, I will follow you all the days of my life in your presence." And all the Father God is asking of you now is to share the smile of God with those whom you meet wherever you live. Because the moment you share the smile of God, you are sharing the Christ light, the healing touch of the crucified Lord. You may never ever see the result of your prayer in this life, but I give you my word that when you volunteer to be a prayer partner for God on earth, when your work on earth is finished and the angels of God come for you to take you home, my belief is very simple. Jesus will introduce you to those whose prayers have supported them. And you will hear now the words from the Father for you, spoken by Jesus, that in your volunteering, you are precious royalty in the kingdom of heaven. You are royalty in the kingdom of heaven. I want to say thank you for allowing me pray with you. And in gratitude, I choose to blow the Christ light from my heart via this candle to your heart. And together, let us blow the Christ light to the children of God suffering and struggling in Gaza, for the release of the Israeli hostages, for the people of Ukraine and Haiti, and for the persecuted Christians in Cairo and in Africa and across the Middle East. Let us now pray God's blessing. Go in peace to love and to serve a loving God. Namaste, shalom, inshallah, pax et bonum, om shanti, solo di caritas, salam alaikum. May the peace, the love, and the joy of the Lord, which is our strength, be with you, remain with you, this day, this night, forevermore. Amen. This beautiful brass crucifix was handed to me when I became a novice on the 8th of December 1966, and it came from our German province, from one of the monks going back to the 14th century. I should have left it when I left the order, but the Lord said, "Take it in commemoration of the life you gave to me as a nursing monk." So I've treasured this for over 55 years, and I shared the blessing of all the monks who've owned this cross with you. Our final video that was chosen in prayer is a gift from my heart to yours. But before I play it, as it's the first evening of the Easter, Triduum, Monday, Thursday, at 8 o'clock London time this evening, I'm doing a 1 hour vigil dedicated to Christ, where we will join with him in the Garden of Gethsemane and listen to some of the most beautiful sacred text chosen by the Holy Spirit and an array of beautiful videos. And if you who are here on YouTube and Facebook wish to come and join us on our Whereby channel, the link I've shared with you on YouTube in the details and now on Facebook. Come, you don't have to reveal your face. You can keep your camera closed. And if you can't join me, maybe tomorrow afternoon at 3 o'clock, you may be free to join me for a commemoration of the greatest love story ever told, or maybe Holy Saturday at 10 o'clock in the evening. I say good night and God bless you from my heart. Thank you for letting me pray with you. Thank you.
God who's never ever far.
night and God bless you all. Thank you for letting me pray with you. And a blessed Easter to all of you gathered here. Amen. So now, dear friends, I take my leave because I must get ready for our 8 o'clock this evening. And now Brother Rob has prepared dinner, so I must be on my way. God bless you, and thank you again for letting me be with you in prayer.